Hello and welcome to today's technical analysis video. My name's Craig Earle, market analyst here at Alpari UK. Let's start today with cable. It's a currency pair that we covered over the last couple of days, really. And we are on the daily chart at least, continuing to see it grind high. We had a pullback today though, so this is looking, you could call it a bearish engulfing pattern if you're looking at the last two candles, or if you look at the last three as a whole. If we see a close below this two-thirds of the way below this green candle here from Monday, then this could actually be an evening star formation, so very bearish here actually. But the 4-hour chart suggests to me that we're not necessarily going to see that. If you look here, we're in a clear defined uptrend here on the 4-hour chart. We can see this area that we highlighted previously, and this was the this swing low to high. On the 4-hour chart, we pulled back, we hit the 50 fib level, where it intersects this ascending trend line, and then continued to push higher. I think what we're seeing here is a case of the pair actually just losing a little bit of momentum at this stage. Previous to this, we did have areas where we were seeing consolidation, and then for continuation of the move higher, and then more consolidation, move higher, when it was moving more aggressively. But now, with the fact that we're seeing a full retracement, 1.8% retracements, all it suggests to me is that the pair is actually losing momentum. I'm not actually seeing any signs yet the pair has actually, we're going to see a reversal. Of course, if we see on the daily candle, if we do see a close below two-thirds way down the on Monday's candle, which like I said a minute ago, would result in an evening star formation, that would give an indication. But the one that would mean more to me, if I'm perfectly honest, is this 4-hour chart. We've got the ascending trend line, we've got this 50 and 61.8 fib levels, and around here we've got the 50 fib level here, along with the 50 period SMA, both intersecting here. Pair is finding support at this level. Below here we've got the 61.8 fib level, and this intersects both the ascending trend line and this trend line here. Now, it's not obvious on this 4-hour chart what that is, but if we look at the weekly chart, that is actually the descending trend line dating back to the 5th of August 2009 that it eventually broke above a couple of weeks ago. So this is a huge level of support actually here on this 4-hour chart, and therefore I do not expect to see a break back below. If we do, then of course this is very bearish, and also that would suggest that we're going to see a daily close below that level which I spoke about, which would result in an evening star formation. So if we see that, then of course, and that is looking significantly more bearish. But as it stands, this is continuing to look bullish for me, and I'll be surprised if we even see a close below the 50 fib level, if I'm honest. But if we do, then I really don't expect to close below here. So this is certainly one worth keeping an eye on. Especially if we do reach this level and we see an aggressive push higher, that would suggest that the bulls are still firmly in control here. Looking at the dollar yen next, and again, we have seen a little bit of a change here. We've seen that bearish engulfing pattern yesterday completed, after the pair found strong resistance around 103.35. That was a previous level of resistance as well. So this is looking pretty bearish in the over the next couple of days. And what I'm seeing here is, despite the fact that we're seeing it hold up around that 50 fib level, which is actually a lot more clearer actually on the 4-hour chart, because previously in the lead up to this, we had an aggressive move higher. We had periods of consolidation, either in the form of a flag formation or a pennant formation, a descending wedge formation. And then we saw it hit those highs, 103.35. We saw the pullback, which was actually, we had the descending trend line on the final descending wedge, which was far more aggressive pullback actually than any of the ones previously, which initially suggested that the pair had lost momentum. But then it also coincided with the 50 fib level of the move from these lows on the 20th of November to the highs on the 3rd of December. So then we saw the continuation of the move here, higher from here. So this already suggested to me that the pair was still looking bullish. But now that we've seen this resistance around 103.35 again and a pullback, I am keeping an eye on the 50 and 61.8 fib levels in case this tells me that we are seeing a continuation of the move higher, at which point this could start to look like another bullish continuation pattern with maybe a longer term ascending triangle forming, something along the lines of this. But I'm not necessarily convinced at this stage that that's what it's going to be. For me, this is shaping up to be a double top formation. I think this is what it's looking like at the moment. If we see both these 50 and 61.8 fib levels taken out, then that is what I think we'll be looking at in the next couple of days, or even in the next week or so. But then if we do see it reach down towards this neckline of the double top, and that'll be around 101.70, then this level is going to be extremely key, because we've been talking about how long we've been waiting for a pullback in the dollar yen pair. And if we saw a break of this 101.70 here, then we'd expect a corresponding move below, which would equate to roughly the same size as the double top formation itself, and that would bring us back below this 200 period SMA on the 4-hour chart, which would of course be a major level of support. But then that would bring us all the way back to around that 100 level. So big level of support and resistance previously, key psychological level. So this break here, this neckline of the double top, if we do see it reach here, it's going to be extremely key for this pair. And to be honest, at this stage, it is looking like we are going to see that. So certainly one to keep an eye on here. Certainly one as well to keep an eye on in case we do see this more as an ascending triangle. So I think this is going to be one of the more interesting pairs. So definitely one worth keeping an eye on here. And then, of course, with that 100 level, if we did see a break of that double top, then that would come in at around 100. So this would be roughly in between this 1561.8 fib as well. So it would actually work out quite nicely if we did see that double top form and break and then pull back. That would give us that significant pullback I've been talking about for weeks, which could then prompt this continuation of the move higher in the longer term, going into the first quarter next year and maybe towards 105 and further on again. So I think this is where the dollar yen is going to get a lot more interesting now, so it's certainly one worth keeping an eye on. Next up, we'll take a look at euro sterling, and we've touched on this one a few times over the last few weeks, and all we've been talking about is how bearish it looks. We had this descending channel formation, which we can clearly see it respected the upper and lower bounds of this channel on a number of occasions. We did see a break above a few days ago, actually it was about 6 days ago, so just under a week ago now, and then following that aggressive breakout, we did have this period of consolidation, which is effectively, well, you could call it a pennant formation or a triangle formation, but it was essentially, it's a period of consolidation, which is a bullish continuation pattern based on the fact that we had that bullish move first. Period of consolidation is usually a bullish continuation pattern. What we've seen today, or in the last couple of hours, actually is that break above the pennant formation, the triangle formation, whichever you choose to call it, and we're now seeing it push higher. We have seen it find resistance around this previous level of resistance here, which comes as no surprise, around 84.13, but this is looking quite bullish now in the very short term, because as I say, in the longer term, this is looking quite bearish. So I guess at this point, while it is looking bullish in the short term, it's got to be a case of looking for the key levels where we could potentially see a reversal forming. And I think the first one has to be this ascending trend line, which is the one it broke below after that longer term descending trend. We saw it finally break below here, tested on a few occasions before continuing this move lower. But we are, I think this has got to be the first obvious potential reversal point for the pair, but I think there could actually be one sooner. You've got this 50-day simple moving average, and if we just had this Fibonacci retracement here, it actually coincides perfectly with that 50-day simple moving average and the 50% retracement level. So that's around 84.17. So I think this is going to be a really key level for the pair, which if we look on the 4-hour chart, comes in just above the current price action. So this could be the point at which we do see a reversal. So certainly something worth keeping an eye out for there, especially if you're in a long position. This does seem to be a logical area of resistance for the pair, and then that's of course followed by just above here around 84. I think that's 84.25, was it? So that comes in around 84.25, which isn't too far above here at all. So you're looking, that's around here. So I really do think this rally now is on borrowed time. I think we are going to see a potential reversal around that area. Looking at the weekly chart though, again, that just confirms what we've already said with this 84.25, 84.20 level, which is the 50 fib, and also that previous level of resistance, as well as the ascending trend line. So all of this is looking very bearish, but we should be aware of this on the weekly chart. This is a descending channel formation on the weekly chart. We have broke below that ascending trend line, but you can see that it is respecting the upper and lower bounds of this trend. So once or if this does turn bearish again, then we've got to be looking for potential support going forward around that 82.30 level and going further lower and going lower as well. Finally, let's touch on dollar Swissy, and again, this is something we've touched on a number of times recently. We've talked about how bearish it is, given the fact that it broke below this ascending trend line back on the 18th of September. We've seen it retest it on a couple of occasions, most recently the 8th of November, and then that prompted an aggressive move lower. If we look on the 4-hour chart, you can actually see something we highlighted previously about this descending channel. And again, it respected the upper and lower bounds on a number of occasions. Most recently, we saw an aggressive attempt to break below. And eventually, we did see that break below. And we highlighted this last time that this break below is extremely bearish for this dollar-Swissie pair. And since then, we've seen an even more aggressive sell-off in the pair. But what we've seen in the last 24 hours is a break below that previous level of support around 88.89, so around 88.90 from the 24th of October. And the interesting thing about this break is that the next level of support really is quite significantly below. The next logical area of support really has to be around 87.57, which is a previous level of support and resistance. I think it's you can see it more clearly actually on the daily chart. So here we've got that level of resistance support that we've just broken below, and then the next level of support comes here. This is from the this is from the 3rd of November in 2011, so that's the next logical area of support for the pair, which is quite significantly below. So as long as we can get a daily, well, we've had a daily close, we've had a retest, so this is now looking even more bearish for the dollar Swissie pair. I'm not seeing any change in that bearish outlook, although I would be a little bit careful at the fact that we've now had six daily candles which we've seen losses on. So I'd say a couple more at most before we potentially see another retest of this 88.86 trend line. Okay, that's all we've got time for today. Join us again tomorrow for another technical analysis video. Thank you.